There's only rubble and debris left after days of strikes by Syrian forces backed by Russian air power. The target, the northern Syrian town of Raheela in Idlib province, the last major rebel-held stronghold. And in Sakareb, activists show the extent of the damage there, an area devastated by barrel bombs.
The bombardment continues here. A helicopter just dropped a bomb.
The Syrian civil defense group, known as the White Helmets, has been working round the clock to rescue those caught in the conflict. Marat al-Numan is now ghostly quiet among the derelict buildings, remnants of artillery used by the rebels. They'd held the town since 2012, a strategic location on the M5 highway, which links Damascus to Syria's second city of Aleppo. Now Syrian soldiers patrol the streets. For those who fled the airstrikes, they joined tens of thousands of others searching safety and heading north towards the Turkish border. The drive by Russian-backed government forces to recapture Syria's last opposition enclave has displaced more than hundreds of thousands of civilians since December, many of them children. The UN has described conditions as bleak.
We're leaving our houses and evacuating Idlib because of the constant airstrikes.
We left Idlib because of the shelling and the bombardment. We are lost. We don't know where to go. And everywhere we go, we find the army is following us. It's cold and raining.
Life here is very tough and difficult. We're displaced. We can't find jobs. The accommodation here is overcrowded with people coming from everywhere.
Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan, who has repeatedly called for Syria's Bashar al-Assad to step down, has threatened to launch a military operation if the strikes continue. He accuses the Russian government of breaking a ceasefire agreement.
If the situation in Idlib does not return back to normal immediately, we will have no choice but to choose the same road. We are also heading to the same crossroad where promises given to us are not being kept.
Moscow has denied targeting civilian areas. But as the bombing continues, Syrians say they're unsure about where they'll go next and if they'll ever return. Raheela Mohammed, Al Jazeera.